Yes, we continue Okay, this hydraulics, I will come later. You see, this is also one non-return valve. You see, also in the connection of the hatch coming some small holes here. You see, it is already wasted too much. So, it is that area, up area, the connection area. Not only waste from the middle, can also waste from the connection. So when you checking the non-return valves, you just try to move by your hand if it is, because if it is already wasted that area, maybe it will be broke. You can understand if there is hole something. Okay, you see here, it is already wasted too much. Also for the non-return valve, you see, I will make it bigger. You see here the butterfly. Şimdi here several problems we can see. Let me check the other side. Yes, this is much more better. Okay, at first this one I want to explain. You see here is the permanent part. Maybe I change the color. White color is better. You see here this part. This part. They tighten too much. Why? How I understand? Because okay, this is much more better. You see, it is banded like this. Correct. They tighten this butterfly too much because you know this coming like this, and this is my ventilation flap. Here is the fixed part like this. And then butterfly going inside here, and then I tighten this one. So this part, I am looking from up here. This is my ventilation flap. This is the butterfly coming like this. If I tighten too much here, I will bend that part. So you see, they bend this one. Too much tightening is not good. Also, when we come to other side, you see, they damage also the foundation of this butterfly. Butterfly itself also bended. Maybe something drop here, damage this one. Okay, maybe when any discharging, I don't know. But this is cross tech actually, not have too much possibility. I think this is already very old. Too much corrosion have here and lose the strength. Okay, this hinge fixed part is bended because of too much tightening. Also, this damaged. You see, this butterfly bended. Also, you see the ears. You see, this is like this. This going like this. It is also damaged. So if you tighten too much, you will damage all. Also inside the packing, over compression. Okay. This is also important. Not tightening too much is not good, my friend. Okay. Also, if you have some problem, in that vessel, pardon. This vessel was very old. Okay. And if only one hatch, only one ventilation flap, okay, you can repair. But that vessel actually was not in good condition. Everywhere have some problem. So we don't have too much time to repair, okay? Because several, almost all of them, all of the ventilations, this is mechanical ventilation cover, okay? Too much problem. All of them in bad condition, poor condition. So we just apply the ram neck like this. Okay. So I just want to check here also if anything. You see, they damage the ears here. This is very, very. They cannot close properly. Also, you see, it is also bended. Too much problem actually. Not too much tighten, my friend. Screw by hand and then only one half tur, okay, Only 180 degree. Not too much tightening by the pipes, something. Otherwise you will damage everywhere. Okay. Yes, this one. You see. Too much damage. You see, it is already. You see, very very poor condition actually. But my friends, sometimes nothing to do. Okay, because maybe too much voyages and you don't have enough time to make hot work, something, some repair. Okay, we are applying the ramneck tape. Okay. Yes, this is the cross connection of the hatch covers. There is some permanent set here, but has to be checked from the manufacturer's book. Yeah, I will speak about the emergency conditions. Okay, for example, I will speak in the cargo hold hatch cover water tightness test about this one. Yeah, it seems like not bad, not good, but not bad also. Okay, have some permanent set, but still seems, anyway, it can continue. But you see here some big permanent set. Okay, why this is happen on the corners? If any photo I show, we speak already about this one. This is another story, very big problem I will speak. Okay, this is another also. I will speak about this one. Anything? No. Bakayım şurası nerede? This is the host test. Anyway, maybe it was there. I just check. Normally, we speak. It is about the 25.5% of the designed compression. Okay, but in the corners, in the actually not the corners, in the cross joints. Okay. There is another thing has to be considered. Don't photo him. Okay, I will. Şimdi here, okay, I will draw, nothing to do. This is my hatch coming, okay. You know, my compression bar. Is coming like this. Also, from the other side, coming like this. And there is some triangle like this here, correct. The main connection of the hatch cover panel, cross connection. So you see here the compression bar increase like a triangle. This area is touching too much more here, not same like here, touching too much more there. And in that corners actually this over compression is, if it is more, probably normal, this is no problem. But the permanent set in here, you see. I change it like this. You see here, some permanent set too much. Here. Actually, it is coming that area. Also, probably same on the other side. Because here, the compression bar increasing. This is normal. And Yeah, if it is not any damage here, here, okay, it is normal. If it is not too much extreme. But what is the main reason for this? When you renew the hatch cover packings, rubbers, if they are not used original spare and they just buy some of the cheap spares, this rubber quality not same with the original one, and then it becoming damaged much more quickly. This is one of the other reason. But even if all of them the original rubber packing, some more allowance is no problem for here. Okay, don't forget. Because of this increase in the compression bar. Okay. And then, okay, we come to this. What is the hydraulic pipes? Şimdi, what is the golden rule with the hydraulic pipes? What I told you, we will cover with the packing, anti-corrosive tape, okay. But anyway, if there is some hole and you need to repair, don't forget. For example, you are opening your hatch cover. You are opening or closing, okay. For any reason, when it is crack open position, when it is crack open position, some leakage on the hydraulic line, and then you stop the pump, the leakage is too much, and you want to repair, okay. Don't forget. Şimdi, if it is in crack open position, all the weight of the hatch cover hold by the hydraulic line, okay? It is going to pump room. It is also coming from here, going to pump room. All the weight, and it is have leakage from here, okay? So, at first you have to lower down, or what I want to tell, never ever make hot work, never, in that condition, very very important. Why? If you apply the oxygen acetylene here, when you cut the pipe, all with the pressure of the hatch cover weight, it will start to overflow the hydraulic oil directly, okay. Will spread, and with the fire of the torch, it will start burning. Very very important. Never ever make hot work in that pressurized condition. Okay, I repeat again. You are closing or opening hatch covers, and there is you observe some leakage on the hydraulic line. Okay, you stop the pump, and then never ever cut by the fire. Otherwise, when you cut all the hydraulic with the pressure of the weight of the hatch cover will spread, and then it will directly get fire. Okay, very very important, because it is happen in one of the vessels. If you need to remove, okay, so normally, okay, I speak about this emergency conditions also. Normally, you have to know about the emergency procedures of the hatch cover, okay? You have to check the manufacturer instructions. This is my hatch coming. This is my hatch covers. You see here is some, for example, it is in the middle, the operation box of the hatch cover panels. You have to check your manufacturer book first. If your hatch covers can close by gravity, okay, because some of the hatch covers can be closed by gravity. Here some bypass valves, there are several small valves around here, okay. So you open this bypass valve. So if it is in crack open condition, you just little open this bypass valve and the, by the gravity, by the weight, it will easy drain the hydraulic to the pump room and the hatch covers will easy close and totally close. Okay, this is one method, but you have to confirm if it is, if you can make like this or not. The other thing is the by the emergency pump. Emergency portable pump. What is portable pump? It is on a hand truck. Okay. There is some pump. Hydraulic pump. Okay. You connect this one to the plug. And then there is some two hose. One pump hose, one suction. On the control box, you will see here some quick connections, something. This is my control box, for example. Some quick connections here. Okay, you connect one here, you connect the other one here, and then you run the pump, and then you open or close. It is very, very important. You make familiar yourself. Actually, it is better, same like a drill, with the engineers. Okay. In one day, one free day, or when you are available, make one operation about this one, and if possible, this one. So you will see if your hatch covers can close by gravity. You can, you confirm, and which valves, which of the bypass valve something, which valve you will operate, which will not operate, and you will see if your bypass valve is working or not. And then you will see if your emergency pump is working. Inside emergency pump have some oil, because sometimes engineers use this one, this become empty. Normally it has to some oil inside. It has to be some oil inside. And the correct oil also, correct number. For example, if your hatch covers operating with 32, number 32 oil, hydraulic oil, okay. If it is inside correct or not, engineers should check also. Also, you make your familiar operating with the emergency procedures. So what I recommend you, when I go vessel, we make this one, and then I prepare in one A4 size paper, I cover with this one with laminating patch film, okay. And I make instructions, işte number one, you, because I draw here again, this is hatch coming, this is hatch cover, this is the control valves. You see, on the down, some hydraulic lines go, both side, also some valves here, correct. Some small valves. So which one? For example, this is number one, number two, number three, number four. You give number, and then before operation, okay, for opening operation, close number one, and then connect this to quick connection num A and quick connection B. Okay, on the emergency pump, I bring the pump here. Okay, there are two hose. For example, işte red hose and blue hose. Okay, blue hose connect to A, red hose connect to B, and then close this valve, and then open this valve, and then start all the operation procedures you make familiar. Also, you see if your pump is working something. It is important, okay. This is also another important thing about this one. Yeah, for the leakage, sometimes nothing to do. And don't forget, actually, for example, your hatch covers operating with number 32 hydraulic, okay. In the emergency conditions, you can use other numbers. For example, in one of the vessel, it was too much old vessel and have too much problem actually. And on the hydraulic line, we were have several leakage. Extreme leakage. Actually, that vessel, this is the vessel, okay. You know, there is some duct keel on the center in the, you enter from engine room, it is going underside of the vessel, a duct keel. Also, in that vessel, under the main deck, there is some duct also here, okay. All the carbon dioxide lines go from one side, fire main line, and the hydraulic lines going inside that duct. not on the main deck. Okay, so it is inside the dock of the starboard side, and nobody checked the condition of the hydraulics. Too much leakage we were have. In one of the port in the China, we go and we try to open the all of the, because they say our vessel was 5-volt. They say we will discharge with the 5-volt, 5-gang. And we start to open hatch covers. We open number 1, number 2, number 3, and when we come number 5, all the oil inside the pump room finish. Okay, and we already use, because of the leakage, all the hydraulic. So there is no hydraulic oil remain on board to use this one. Okay, so what we happen, we go to forward windlass. Because you know, in the windlass pump room, there is some oil storage tank. Okay. For example, our hydraulic oil for the hatch covers number 32. But for the windlass, it was 100. What I remember. Okay, number for the, I write here. For the hatch cover, it was number 32. But for the windlass, it was number 100. Anyway, nothing to do. We take some oil, put inside the pump, and we operate the hatch cover. In the emergency conditions, with approve of the company, okay, you can make something like this. But when finish, when receive the spare, you have to change all the oil inside the pump. This is another story also. Anyway, but you can make this one. What will happen? It will affect the operation performance. Okay, performance, and it will reduce to, it will affect, it will affect the lifetime, lifetime of the all the equipments. Okay, piston, everything, the pump, something, something. Okay, but in emergency conditions, don't forget, you can change the hydraulic line, not if nothing to do. Okay, or you speak with the before, if you need to make something like this, speak with the company. They must give permission this one. But in that case, we were at the port, there was nothing to do. We make something like this. Okay, here so I want to speak about this one. How many minutes happen? Okay, 22. Here some oil leakage, and they put temporary repair rubber patch and jump lee clip and shipboard made system to contain hydraulic oil leakage from the hydraulic piping and cylinders. Okay. What is the important point here? I want to open one picture. We continue with the photos again. Not this. Yeah, actually, I can delay it because we already speak about until here. We already speak. Correct. This is gone. This one. Also, we speak this one. Already gone. Correct. Şimdi, I want to open one document. Here. This is one of the vessel. I prepare report about the hydraulics of the cylinders of the hatch cover. You see here. Okay. Şimdi in that photo I want to show something. Yes. And I make it bigger, much more better. Yes. Şimdi this is the hydraulic piston. Okay. What is important here? Okay, I draw the piston. With the gray color, do we have gray? Okay, in that color. This is the piston itself. Going down, correct. Like this. In here. Okay, inside this gray color, the jacket of the piston. Here. There is a dust sweeper ring. Okay. Yeah, I don't remember the exactly technical name, but the purpose is when the dust coming from outside and maybe stuck up the piston something, when go inside the piston, it's sweeping the dust and cleaning the piston, so no contamination with the hydraulic oil. Okay, there is a dust sweeping ring here in the beginning, and then underside of this one there is a oil sweeping rubber gasket here. Okay, here maybe this color is not very good, maybe this is much more better. Yes, okay. There is a second ring, but this is rubber. Rubber, oil, sweep, ring. Okay. So, if there is some problem with this dust sweeper ring, okay, all the dust will easy go down until that oil sweep ring. Okay. And then by up and down of the piston, by the time it will damage your ring. And then start oil leakage from here. This is very, very important. Okay. So what I recommend you, I want to show one picture. Normally in the Klinger loadings, okay, the cement loading, Klinger loading, I open from there. This one. You see, the deck team makes some canvas to protect the piston from the dust of the cement and Klinger. Okay, but what is the golden rule here? After operation, okay, you remove this covers, because in the idea of you keep this one on the piston, so it will protect the piston. Actually, this is not like this. By the time you see the condition here, you see already some opening, some holes here. It is becoming poor condition, and all the dust go inside and accumulate in the bottom of the piston. Okay, and then the result is that. The result. When I go that vessel, all the pistons covered by the tarpaulin to protect from the dust of the cargos. Okay. When I go, I immediately remove all of them, because all of them were very, very rusty. Okay. And then there were some small leakage also, because you see here the oil sweep ring already removed, start to remove inside, because all the dust go down. Okay, and then will damage the oil sweep ring, and then start to, you see the hydraulic oil start to leakage. Also you see the condition of the piston is not good. You see here is the fine cover already gone. So by opening and closing easy it is damaging the oil sweep ring and start leakage. You see here is very, very big. You see it is already go down and too much oil leakage from there. So don't forget. Okay, you see too much leakage everywhere, becoming leakage. So in the beginning of the contract it was like this. At the end of the contract, it was same like peeing from here. It was going like this. Too much. It becoming too much, extremely oil leakage from the pistons. Okay, this is very, very important, my friend. So you have to cover the pistons properly. Okay. Ha, during operation, during loading, cement, Klinger, okay, cover. But after operation, remove. When you go to discharging discharging port, open and cover again. When you discharge, complete discharging, okay, remove again. Otherwise, the result is this one. Okay, very very important. You see, it's already gone. This is too much coming actually. Bakayım var mı burada? This is another thing. You see here also. Now too much pistons like this actually. Very very bad condition. You see here already come out. It is also same. Too much. All of yani half of the pistons in that condition. Yeah, I prepare a report about this one. And before the shipyard, actually in that vessel, we go to shipyard also, and I make report about this one, and we sent the company, but they didn't make anything. You see, it's like water, huh? Water, it is coming, too much coming. We sent the company, but they didn't touch the pistons on the shipyard because they say it is too much expensive, but it will be much more expensive, I think, by the time with that problem. You see. Yes. You see here inside, there is a dust sweeping ring, and underside, there is a oil sweeping ring. So, don't cover all the dust inside the tarpaulin will accumulate here. That area, and too much dust will damage the dust sweep ring and then go inside the piston and then damage the oil sweep ring. Okay, this is also another important thing. You see, it is already the fine cover of the piston already gone here also. Too much, too very very poor condition actually. Okay, you see here, too much problem. Yes, this is gone. Okay. And then, one of the important thing, you see here some greasing points. They already, here is the greasing nipple, one greasing nipple here, correct, one greasing nipple here. But in some of the pistons, okay, not all of them, but in some of them, also one greasing, maybe it is better I make green color, yellow color, same color. In some of the piston, have some greasing nipple around here, okay? In some, not all of them. So, if there is some greasing nipple here, check. Okay, check from the instructions. Because, okay, you can apply grease here. And you can observe grease come from outside, okay? Here is no problem. Also, here same. Also, in the down, what is the normal procedure with the greasing? Not this one, pardon. You apply grease from the nipple and you observe here connections, correct? Old grease come out. Until see new clean grease, okay, we continue with the by hand or with the pneumatic greasing pump something. But here is the situation is different, okay. Yes. If there is a greasing nipple here around that, around the top of this here, okay. So check the manuals because yeah, the vessel I was working. What I remember is about 2 milliliter grease. You know the vagination shrink, huh? Here like this we apply the nipple. So here is 1 milliliter, 2 milliliter, 3 milliliter, very very little, same like this one. You have to confirm from the instruction. If you directly apply by hand pump too much grass, you will damage the this rings inside also. Or with the pneumatic grazing pump, you will damage too much also. Only just very very little. So the quantity of the grass you have to confirm from the manufacturer instruction, okay. If there is some grazing nipple around here, and don't forget to remove this one, okay. This is very very big headache. Only during the operations, okay. And this is another. Okay, we speak about this one also. This one, I am erasing. And then this group, then also correct, and then yeah, this is also another type of non-return valve. Okay, don't forget, if any problem, always check also here if any corrosion, any vestige around here. Also, if any problem, you cannot change the spare. Okay, put your fire hose and secure from there. Finish the story. Okay, don't forget this one. I erase this one also. We speak about this one also. Okay, the another topping you see here. Anyway, I will speak about this one in the test part. Also, we şimdi we come to here. Rubber packings, okay. Rubber packings. How we will? How many minutes happen? 36. Anyway, the rubber packing I will make in the next video. Okay, I want to speak about that valves. Okay, you see here on the hydraulic line there are some valves like this. What is that valves? Okay, I draw here. These are circulation valves. Okay. This is my vessel. This is my hatch coming. All the vessel way. This is my hatch covers. Okay. For example, here is my pump room. In the cold climate, okay, here, all the hydraulic lines going from the deck, from the hatch covers to the pump room, correct? Going like this, it's going like this. And then this hydraulic line actually two way. One going all the hatch covers like this. Maybe it is better I draw here. It will be much more better like this. This is my hatch coming. This is my hatch cover. The hydraulic line go like this and then coming to back to the pump room. Okay. And then from here going to hatch cover, for example, number 3, number 2, number 1. Going like this, going like this. One of the collector, one of the suction. Not suction, but the pump and receive. So you will see there will some valves. In some vessels have two valve forward and aft. In some vessels only one valve in the forward. No problem. Even if two valve, even if one valve, no problem. For example, if this vessel, five hold vessel, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. You will see beside the aft part of the number 5, close the aft part, also close the forward part of number 1. These valves are for cold weather. Circulation valves, okay. Circulating valves. Okay. When the weather is cold, you open these two valves and then you run the pump. So the pump makes circulate the oil inside the line, so prevent from the freezing. Okay, these valves for that purpose. Also, normally, that valves normally close valves. Okay, normally close. So when you are operating hatch cover, these valves must be in closed position. Okay, must be in closed position. When you go to cold climate, not operating the hatch covers, okay, you make them open. Open the valves, circulate the oil inside, so prevent cooling, freezing. Okay, but which vessel I go? Old vessels, not new deliver vessels. All that valves stuck up. Okay. Pardon. This one. These valves are stuck up. Cannot operate because very long time not used. Okay. So don't forget, if any possibility you will go to cold climate, you have to check that valves in the forward part, very close to number one and number five. Sometimes only one valve close the forward hold. Okay, forward hold and aft hold. Okay, these valves you check if you can operate. You see it is now in closed position. So, but when we try to turn this one, we cannot turn actually. So it is stuck up. Not force this one by hand. If you cannot open, okay, inform engineers. They try. If they spare, okay, change this one. If don't have spare, it will be problem because trying to opening, maybe if you break the valve, this valve, and then maybe you cannot put it again, so it will be problem. Okay, but this valve is important for the cold climates. And also don't forget, this normally close this valves. Okay, but I work in only one vessel. Even if you can open this one or close this one, no problem, you can operate the hatch covers. Okay, but normally close that valves. Okay, don't forget about this one. Okay, my friends, already we have the time. Okay, we continue with the next video. Okay.